Okay, good morning and welcome you all. This is the video recording for the lab experiment that you people are going to conduct at your colleges. This lab experiments are part of 1000 teachers training program that is planned for December 12 to 22, and the objective of this videos are to record the instructions of how to conduct the lab experiments so that the coordinators at various remote centers can take help of these videos, or even the participant can look at these videos and then accordingly conduct this experiment at their premises. So in this program I will mainly cover three lab experiments which are related to the photovoltaic modules. This lab experiment, the lab experiment number one is identifying and measuring IV characteristic of a PV module. Experiment number two is series and parallel connection of a PV modules, and the experiment number three is effect of sun tracking on energy generation in a PV system. So I will first give you the theory about these lab experiments, how what is the basic idea, how the experiment has to be performed, and after this theory is explained here, we will also show you how to conduct the experiment with the actual setup, and the same setup is going to be given to your remote center, same setup will be available at your remote center so that you can exactly do the similar experiment and hopefully learn a lot from this experiments. So let me start. So let me start explaining the experiment number one. But basically, in the all three experiment, PV module is the main device which you need to measure. And therefore, I will start with explaining the basic features and basic parameters of a PV module. And once we understand those basic parameters, I will show you how the one can find out the characteristic of a module. So experimental experiment number one, identifying and measuring IV characteristic of a PV module. First of all, the PV modules that are provided to you are basically monocrystalline silicon PV module and multicrystalline silicon PV module. The one way to identify between the monocrystalline and multicrystalline silicon module is that the monocrystalline silicon module have the cells which are pseudo square in nature. So typically you have this kind of arrangement. Now the cells are normally very big, and typically they are cut into smaller pieces. So when the cells are cut in smaller pieces, you'll see one part of the cell which is looking like this. So and this is what is the case of a monocrystalline silicon. Monocrystalline silicon cell will look like this, but if you look at the multicrystalline silicon, normally the multicrystalline silicon cells are perfectly square or rectangular in nature. Again, the dimension of the cells can also be very big, and therefore again they are cut into smaller pieces, so the smaller piece will look something like this. So the basic, and this is a case for the multicrystalline silicon. So the basic difference that you can see between the mono and multicrystalline silicon is that in the monocrystalline silicon cells, the cells will be there rounded, will have the round corner, while in case of multicrystalline, the cell will be either square or rectangular. And because of this arrangement, because of this, when the next cell is, when the cells are connected in series, for example, if this cell is connected in series here, you will have this kind of arrangement, and therefore, and this will continue. While these cells are connected in series, you will have this kind of arrangement. So what you can see is this number of cells here will have this kind of space which are empty, and which is looking, which will look as a white space in your PV module, and that is what identification of a monocrystalline silicon. But if you have the multicrystalline silicon, because they are rectangular in nature, they can very tightly be fit into the module, and you will not see the white spaces and that is identification of a multicrystalline silicon. So when you do the experiment in your center, first try to identify which module is a monocrystalline module and which module is a multicrystalline silicon module. Second thing is, in module you will see many cells are connected in series, and the reason for that is to get a higher open circuit voltage of the module. And therefore, normally in either monocrystalline silicon or in multicrystalline silicon, there are 36 cells connected in series. So you'll find that 36 cells are connected in series in both the cases. Okay, so second thing, when you go to do the experiment, we need to do is count the number of cells that are connected in series and also check the connection. Okay, so when you have the series connection of the cells, basically your cells are sitting like this. The top side of the cell where you have the metal, contacts is a negative side. So when the cells are like this, series connection of the cells means the top side of the contact is actually connected to the back side. Okay, similarly for the next cell, the top side is connected to the back side. And the same arrangement will be continued for the 36 cells connected in a module. This will happen both for the monocrystalline silicon cells, same thing will happen also for the multicrystalline silicon cells. So once you start doing your experiment, first of all find out which is monocrystalline, which is multicrystalline silicon module. Second thing, find out whether there are 36 cells in both the modules or not. And third thing is, find out whether there is a series connection between the cells or not. Okay, so this is how you can identify a module and the series and parallel connection and monocrystalline and multicrystalline cells in a module. So let us now look at the characteristic of a PV module. In order to find out the characteristic of a PV module, we know that a PV cell is nothing but a PN junction diode, and the characteristic of a PN junction diode is something like this. Okay, this is the current axis, this is the voltage axis. A solar cell is nothing but a PN junction diode under the light condition, and because of the light generated current, the characteristic of a solar cell is given by the blue curve. So this is your diode and this is your solar cell. Okay, so solar cell mainly operates in the fourth quadrant because the current is negative and the voltage is positive, which means power is negative, and because of the negative power, power generation occurs. In this quadrant, first quadrant, where current is positive and voltage is positive, your power is positive. So in this case, in this quadrant, P is V into I, positive power. In this case, P is minus I into V, and because of this negative sign, the power is generated. Okay, here the power generation occurs. And here in this case, the power consumption occurs, right. So we are interested mainly in the power generation. So this part of the IV curve, which is the fourth quadrant, current is negative, voltage is positive, is the most important part of a solar cell and therefore also solar PV module. So in practice, when we draw the IV curve of a module or a cell, we draw the current axis and we draw the voltage axis. And this is actually drawn like this. Okay. The difference between this graph and this graph is that here the y-axis is actually a negative current axis, and then this is a positive voltage axis. So normally, whenever you see in the textbook or anywhere else, the solar cell characteristic or a module characteristic is shown like this. So normally, this is what we draw. Now in this experiment, the whole idea is to measure the IV characteristics of the PV module and find out various parameters of the characteristic. Now from this from this diagram, you can see that there are some parameters which are very clear. For example, this point, which is the highest current which will occur at V equal to 0. Okay. So, V equal to 0 means short circuit. So, this is normally referred as a short circuit current. This is another interesting point. This is the point when current is equal to 0 in this axis. Current is 0 means, current is 0 means open circuit. So, this point is known as open circuit voltage of module. Okay. Other important thing is at what point your module will give you the maximum power. Okay. For example, if your module is working at this point, short circuit current, so current is very high but voltage is 0, so no power is generated at this point. If your module is working here, very high voltage but 0 current, which means no power is generated at this point also. Right. Similarly, if I take the various points, if I take the various points and find out the current and voltage at those points, if I take the various points and find out the current and voltage at that point, I will find out at what point you will get the maximum power point. Okay. So, another graph, if I plot the another graph on this axis, so if I extend this graph like this, okay, where this is my VOC condition. So, instead of current versus voltage, if I draw the power P versus V, if I draw the P versus V, what we will find out that this graph actually goes like this. Okay. So, this is my power versus voltage. So, I know that very at this condition, short circuit condition, there is a 0 power. At open circuit condition, there is a 0 power, but in between point you will get the maximum power, and therefore I want to get maximum power from my module, and therefore my normal operating point should be this point. Okay. So, if I extend this point there, okay, so this is the, let us say, operating maximum point. So, current at this point is given as Im. Okay, that is the current at the maximum point, and this point here is Vm, that is the voltage at the maximum point, and this point itself is corresponding to Pm or Pmax, that is the maximum power that you can get from your module. So, this is what we need to find out by doing the experiment. So, if I give you a module of a certain characteristic, your job will be to go to the terrace, measure the current and voltage at various points, and find out these parameters. Find out what is ISC, find out what is IM, find out what is Pmax, find out what is Vm, and find out what is VOC. Okay. Now, one other important parameter is the efficiency of the module. Okay, other important parameter is efficiency of PV module. Efficiency of the PV module can be obtained, of course, given by P out divided by P in. Okay. So, now what is P out? P out is the maximum power that you can get from your module. So, therefore, efficiency can be given by P max divided by P in. Okay. What is your P max? P max is a product of Im into Vm, that is your product. So, then you have the Im into Vm, and what is your P in? P in is the measured value of the power, measured value of the power density. Okay. So, normally P in is given in terms of watt per meter square, this you are going to measure, and if you multiply by your area of the module, then you will get the watt. So, this you will get the ratio of watt over watt. So, P in, so normally you have to also multiply by the area. So, your P in will be the measured power density multiplied by the area. What is this area? This area is the module area. So, you have to get the multiplied by the area. How do you get this area? This area you, how do you get this P in? That is the measured value. This value can be measured either by pyranometer or even with the help of solar cell. Approximate value can be measured by pyranometer. And this reading is given in terms of watt per meter square. The actual radiation condition outside atmosphere can vary from very low radiation intensity, that is 100 watt per meter square, to up to 1000 watt per meter square. So that we need to find out, that we need to also measure. If you can find out the V in area, you can measure IM, VM, you can measure all other parameter, you can measure, and therefore one can also measure the efficiency. Okay, so this is the another parameter. So when we want to measure the characteristic of a PV module, we need to measure all these parameters. Now the question is how we can measure. So once you are given a PV module, how we can measure it, that I will show you now. So let us now look at the measurements, how you can perform the measurements. Okay, basically what I want to do is, again, what I want to do is I want to find out this characteristic. This is my current axis, and remember this is a negative current axis, this is my voltage axis. Okay, first of all, it is very easy to measure the short circuit current. So if you take a PV module, if you just take a PV module, so you take a PV module and the symbol of PV module is like this. Okay, and there are two terminals at the back side. Let us say one is positive terminal and one is negative terminal. So if you take a your ammeter and if you connect ammeter across this, so if you just connect your ammeter here like this, then you are going to get a short circuit current. So it is very easy to find out this particular point. So you can easily find out the short circuit current. Same thing, you can also find out the open circuit load. So in this condition, because of the low resistance of ammeter, this terminals are of the module is shorted, and whatever current flow is a short circuit current. Now this is the point is called the open circuit voltage, VOC. If you want to find out the open circuit voltage of module, again what you need to do is set the multimeter in a voltmeter mode, and voltmeter have a very high resistance or infinite resistance, and therefore it behaves as if it is an open circuit. In this case, if you connect your voltmeter across the two terminals of a module, you will actually measure this particular point, open circuit voltage of the module. Fine. Now the important thing is how to find out the other points in between. How we can find out the other points in, what are the other point? Other point is a different combination of current and voltage, and we know that somewhere here you get the maximum power. Here your, at this point your power is 0, at this point your power is 0, but somewhere in between your power, that you can get maximum. So basically what we need to do is find out the current and voltage points at various current and voltage points across the full range of power or operating point that module can operate. How to do it? So the way to do it is like this. If you can make the arrangement, which is the normal arrangement that we can make, is again you take a PV module. So this is your PV module. Let's say this is your positive terminal and this is your negative terminal. So the device that is used to find out this point is another rheostat that you can use, and we know that depending on the value of the resistance, the shape of the IV curve will change, right? So for example, if I if I plot the I and V for a resistor R, okay, it will follow basically the Ohm's law, V equal to IR, right? So it will be a slope like this. This is maybe R1, okay. Similarly, if I have another resistor, it may have this kind of slope, R2. If I have another resistor, it may have slope R3 like this, okay. So in this case, assuming this is a negative current x, positive voltage x, in this case higher the slope means lower is the value of resistance, okay. Higher the slope means lower is the value of resistance. Basically R can be given here by delta V by delta I, okay. When the slope is higher, there is a larger change in the current and the smaller change in voltage. Smaller change in voltage means lower value of R. In this case, in this line, there is a larger change in voltage, okay. Okay, so this is the delta V and this is your delta I. So if we are talking about R3, R3 basically in this case is a larger smaller, larger change in the delta V, smallest change in the current, and therefore it R3 represents higher value of resistance, R2 represents lower value of resistance, R1 represents even lower value of resistance. Okay. Suppose same thing is happening. Suppose I find a way in which I connect a resistor across the module in such a way that like this. Okay. So basically the intersection point of a blue curve, which is the resistance curve, and the black curve, which is the module curve. Okay. And the intersection point will be the operating point. Okay. What are this various line represents? The various line represents different value of resistances. Okay. Various line represent different value of resistance. This point is corresponding to short circuit, zero resistance. This point is corresponding to open circuit, infinite resistance, right? So therefore, as I go from this point to this point to this point, my value of resistance is increasing, right? So therefore, what I need to do, if I connect a PV module with a rheostat where I can change the resistance, okay, from very low value of resistance, almost 0 ohm, to a very high value of resistance depending on the current and voltage, I can actually measure all this point, okay. So coming back here, if I actually connect a variable resistance in this case, okay, and if I connect a meter here, okay, then this circuit is closed, but I also want to measure my open circuit voltage. So then I also connect one old meter here and measure these two points, okay. So I am changing the resistance value from very low resistance so that I can get the point this one, and then I keep increasing the voltage resistance. As I keep increasing the resistance, I get this point, then I get this point, and then I get this point. So as I am changing my resistance, I am getting this point, and then higher resistance, I will get this point, even higher resistance, I will get this point, I get this point, I get this point, this point, and finally I can measure open circuit and short circuit, right. So at each point you need to measure your current and voltage, which can be done by two setups. So at each point you change your resistance value, note the value of the current and the value of the voltage, change your resistance value, measure the value of current and value of the voltage, change your rheostat till you go from the one side to other side. So this this actually is your variable resistance that you need to have, right. How many points you should take? As many as you can. Okay. So normally you should have about 10 to 20 points. So therefore make sure that you do not change very large value of resistance. So after this point you should not get this point directly, right. So you are missing this point. So you should get many points in between. So for one IV characteristic there should be about 10 to 20 points that you must measure. Fine. How you can do, what you can do after, you can make a observation table. Your observation table will be like this. You have serial number, value of voltage, value of current, and value of power, right. So your serial number one can be a condition when you have the short circuit current. So zero voltage, which is this point, okay, zero voltage and whatever current you will measure, let's say 1 ampere, and the power is zero, and here you keep on registering your voltages, and the power is actually product of V into I. Okay, power is V into I. So you find out the product, and this you need to calculate. And keep on calculating. After doing this observation, you can plot the graph between current and voltage, and you will find this kind of graph. You also need to plot the power versus voltage, and you have this kind of graph. This current versus voltage, power versus voltage, you need to find out. Once you know the P max, this is the maximum power point. Once you know the P max, you can also find out the efficiency, where your P max, P in, what is your measured power, multiplied by the area of the module, right. In this way, you can find out all the parameters, you can find out. So suppose at a given point, suppose this point is your P max. Okay, suppose this point is your corresponding to P max, and then this corresponding point will be this corresponding point will be Im, that is a current at maximum power point, and the corresponding point will be Vm, that is voltage at maximum power point. Okay, so if you do this, if you do this, all this measurement, you can find out entire parameters of a module: short circuit current, open circuit voltage, maximum power point, current at maximum power point, voltage at maximum power point, and the efficiency. There is one more parameter that you can find out, that is the fill factor, and fill factor is the ratio of Im into Vm divided by Isc into Voc. Im into Vm divided by Isc into Voc. The fill factor represent the fill of the, or the squareness of the curve. Okay, so typically the fill factor for crystalline silicon solar cell will be about 70 to 75%. Okay, so for example, if I have two modules, one is having IV curve like this, another is having IV curve like this. This is module number 1, module number 2. As you can see, this module number 1 is more square, so which means the fill factor of this module will be higher as compared to the module number 2 which is less square, and definitely the maximum power point here will be lower. So this module IV is here and this module is here, so the module number 2 will have the lower maximum power point, which means lower fill factor, even though the short circuit current and open circuit voltage is same. Fine. So this is the basic theory of measuring the IV characteristic of a PV module, and by doing this you can do the measurement. You can also cross check your measurement with what is given at the back side of the module. So at the back side of the module you will find the rated value of current, voltage and power, and you see, just check the rating that you got, that you got from your experiment, how different it is from the rated measurement and from the rated values and your actual measurements. Okay, there are two reasons why the values will be different. For example, P max, which is the rated value, will be given at actually 1000 watt per meter square. So when you are doing measurement, you most likely the chance that you will not get 1000 watt per meter square. Okay, and your P max, your power that you will get, power is proportional to the input radiation, right? So if your at your 1000 watt per meter square, if your P max is let's say 100 watt, okay, at 1000 watt per meter square P max is 100 watt, then at 500 watt per meter square your P max will only be half of this, so that is 50 watt. So you will get only 50 watt. So the output power is proportional to the input power density, and there is a very good chance that your input power density or the actual radiation measured during the time of the experiment will be lower than 1000 watt per meter square, which is the standard test condition, and therefore you may measure the lower value of the power. But nevertheless, make the comparison at the end of the experiment. In your manual that is provided to you, there are many questions. There are many questions at the end of the manual, so please try to answer those questions based on the description that I have provided here, and also based on the measurement that you are going to do. Thank you. Okay, hello. So let me introduce you to the various components that can be used for the experiment, lab experiment that are planned under this 1000 teachers training program. So one important part of this lab kit is this solar PV modules. There are 4 PV modules here, and this kit has arrangement to put this modules at any angle. Okay, so one can adjust this angle to the way they want. In fact, one can make it almost vertical, and the advantage of doing this vertical is that the back side of the module are available to you, and you can make various connections of the module at the back side. At the same time, you can also read the rated value of the modules at various current and voltage parameters. So these are the back side of the PV modules. You can see here, this is the cover which can be opened. So this cover can come out, and now you have the two connections which are here. The small one is the diode that comes as for the protection purpose, called the bypass diode. But these are the two basic main points across which one can do the measurement, and one needs to do the measurement. Also look at the back side of the PV module, specifically the characteristic that is mentioned here. So if you look at this module, this has a maximum power of 10 watt. It has a maximum power voltage VMP of 17 volt. It has the maximum power current IMP of 0.59 ampere. It has a short circuit current of 0.61 ampere. It has an open circuit voltage of 21 volt, and it also mentions the maximum system voltage of 600 volt. That is the maximum system voltage it can withstand. It also says that all the parameters, this parameters which is mentioned here, are given under STC condition, which is standard test conditions of 25 degree centigrade and 1000 watt per meter square, air mass 1.5 is a spectrum. So these are the modules. You can actually open all this modules, and we can do the various measurement using this. Okay, again, this setup is made in such a way that you can actually change the angle of P modules and keep it at any angle you want. Normally the modules should be installed at an angle equal to the latitude angle of the location, and depending on the place where you are in the country, if your latitude is 8 degree, then keep this angle at 8 degree. If your latitude is higher, then you can keep it higher. So this setup will give you the possibility of keeping at any other angle and actually accessing the modules at the back side also. Now depending on the requirement, either you can do the measurement for one single module, or you can actually put two modules in series and you can do the measurement, or you can put two modules in series, these two modules in series, and do the measurement, or you can do the two modules in parallel, or these two modules in parallel, and you can do the measurement. So there are various measurements that are possible in a series as well as the parallel combination of the modules, and this system, this setup of the four PV modules gives you all the flexibility that you want in order to characterize a PV module under various conditions, series combination, parallel combination, and all that. Okay, now in order to measure this values, you need to have the various resistances, and you also need to have the voltmeter and ammeter. Okay, so for using a voltmeter and ammeter, we are showing you the example of two multimeters. One can be used in a voltmeter mode, other can be used in a ammeter mode. Okay, so this is one setup that you require, and the other you require is the resistance. Resistance is the load that you need to connect, and as discussed in theory, the resistance value will vary from very low value of resistance to a very high value of resistance. Resistance requirement depend on the voltage and current. So for example, the resistance follows the Ohm's law, the current and voltage will follow the Ohm's law. So if you are trying to measure 21 volt at 0.2 ampere, so 21 divided by 0.2 is your resistance, and you will get about 100 ohm. Okay, so depending on what you want to measure, for example, if you are connecting four modules in series, so you are trying to measure something like about 60-70 volt at 0.1 and 0.1 ampere current, so your resistance value is 60 divided by 0.1, that is 600 ohms. So then you require a rheostat of 600 ohm. In this case, it is thought that either you will measure one module in series, one single module, or two modules in series, or two modules in parallel, or two modules in series, two modules in series, and both of them in parallel. So basically, in all possible condition, it is estimated that you will require a total rheostat value resistance of about 200 ohm. So you will vary resistance from very low value short circuit condition of about 0 ohm to open circuit condition of about 200 ohm. Therefore, either you will have one single rheostat which have the resistance range from 0 to 100, or you will have a rheostat which will have the value from 0 to
200. So let me show you that how the value of resistance changes from the low to higher side. So if you look at this one particular case, and what you need to do is you need to slide this from one side to the other side, okay. Sliding one side to other side is giving you various combination of resistances, and as discussed in theory, you need to actually measure about 10 to 20 points. So therefore, you need to slide slightly so that you have about 20 points, right. So you have to slide slowly from one position to other position such that there are 20 points. So let us see how much resistance value varies as you go from one side to other side. Okay, so now this is the rheostat, and rheostat has to be connected like this. One point to be connected here, other point is connected the back side, you can see here. If you connect both this point here, this will give the this point and this point here and here will give the total value of the resistance. If you connect one point here and one point here, it will give the value of resistance between this point, which is point connected here, and this point, right. So right now we are measuring the value between this two point, and as this slider will move, you are going to measure the higher value of resistance. So right now you can see this multimeter in the ohms mode, resistance mode. So you can see the value of resistance is about 3 ohm. So very, very low value, now about 1 ohm. And as I move from one side, so that is the 1 ohm means you are actually close to the short circuit point, right. As we discuss in theory, very low value of resistance means your module will operate in a short circuit mode. So now if I move the slider, as you can see the value has now come down to 7.7 ohm. Move slightly, now you have the 13 ohm here. We move further, we get the 20 ohm. In this way, the different position of the slider on this rheostat is going to give you different value of resistance, okay. As you can see, 27.5 ohm. So basically you need to get about anything between 10 to 20 values, and I suggest that there should be at least about 15 values so that you can actually find out your maximum power point very precisely. So as you can go from here to here, you can see the value of resistance is changing, 52, 56, 57, 64, 74, 84, and if you go to the extreme position, you will get the value close to what it is designed for. So this rheostat is designed for 93 ohm, okay. Now if you are going to measure a condition, for example, higher voltage and lower current, as I said, if you want to measure, if your point is at about 30 volt and 0.1 ampere, so 30 divided by 0.1 is 300 ohm. And therefore, one such rheostat is not going to be sufficient. In that case, what you can do is you can connect two of them in series, and then you can connect two of them in series, and you can put them together in series so that total 100 plus 100, you can get 200 ohm resistance. So in your experiment, either you will have one single rheostat of 100 ohm, or you will have one rheostat of 200 ohm, or you will have two single rheostat of 100 ohm each. So you can put them in series and do the experiment. In the first experiment, when you are going to measure only IV characteristic of one single module, and as you can see here from the rating, the maximum voltage that you can get is 17 volt and your current is going to be about 0.1 minimum that you want to measure, and therefore so your resistance requirement is well within the 100 ohm range. So if you have one single rheostat, you can very well characterize one single module. If you are connecting two modules, three modules, four modules in parallel, again one single rheostat is going to be sufficient for all the power, all the data points that you want to measure. But if you want to connect two of them in series, or three of them in series, or four of them in series, then you require higher value of rheostat, and one rheostat of 100 ohm may not be sufficient. Okay, so now let us try to characterize the IV characteristic of a one single PV module. Okay, so IV characteristics of single PV module, we need to have the following connection. Here is our PV module, it has a plus and minus connection. This PV module is connected in series with ammeter and our load is nothing but a rheostat, and this circuit is completed, and in parallel we need to connect a voltmeter so that you can measure the voltage also. Let us now try to make the circuit and we can measure the various data points. So for making the connections, several cables like this will be provided. Okay, these cables can be used to make the series and parallel connection. What we need to do is that these are the two points across which we need to measure the current and voltages. So before we make the circuit, let me show you two data points which we can measure without anything. That is a short circuit current when the module is shorted, and open circuit voltage when module is open circuited. Both of this can be measured only with the help of multimeter. So when you put the module, when we put your multimeter in the current mode, current mode basically low resistance of your multimeter, and therefore you provide the condition for the short circuit. And I'm going to put it. This is milli 20. Okay, I'm going to put this in 10 amperes range. As from my module characteristics says this, my maximum current, which is a short circuit current, is only about 0.61 ampere. So I'm not going to measure more than 0.61 ampere current. So if I put my module multimeter in this category, in this connection, and if I measure the current across two points, what my module will tell me is the short circuit current. Where's the polarity? So you can see here, the current that it is measuring right now is 0.11 ampere. And it is showing the negative sign because the polarity is not connected. If we change the polarity, now it is giving me plus 0.12 ampere, right? So in this way, this is the short circuit current of your module. Okay. Now same way, if I change the connection here and use this multimeter in a voltmeter mode, voltmeter means very high value of resistance, which means I can actually create the open circuit conditions. So if I take this lead here, put this in a voltage term, black one is common, and then I put in 20, in about 20 volt range. As per my module characteristic here, the maximum open circuit voltage, it is about 21 volt. So I'm going to measure less than 21 volt. So let us put now in a voltage mode, and therefore let me measure the voltage between those two points. Okay, what you can see here is voltage is 18.93 volt. Now this is a open circuit voltage condition. Again, by mistake, if you change the polarity of connection, what you will notice here is a negative sign. So here, because the polarity is now changed, you can get the minus 18.90 volt, right? So if your polarity is not correct, you will have the negative sign appearing here. So by, without any measurement, you can always find out the you can find out the short circuit current of your module, and you can find out the open circuit voltage of your module. This you not only you can do for a single module, but you can do the this measurement of short circuit current and open circuit voltage of combination of modules. You can do the same measurement for two modules connected in series, four modules connected in series, or modules connected in parallel. So using multimeter only you can do the series and parallel connection. Now we need to find out other data points also, because we need to plot the whole IV characteristic, okay, from short circuit current to the various points to the open circuit voltage. So we want various data point of current and voltage on the IV curve of a PV module, and therefore we need to use the rheostat, and we need to complete this circuit, right? So let us make this circuit connections for making this circuit now. So we can use this cables, we can use cables like this, and we make a connection at one point. So now the connection to characterize a single PV module is ready. So here you can see two wires are coming, one from the positive and negative. One wire is going like this, and it is going to this meter, which is acting as a meter. You can see the connection here. This is the current meter, this going in series. This is connected to the rheostat here. And then the second wire of the cable is going back to the module. So this, in this way, you are connecting one circuit, okay, which is same as shown here. So you have the module plus side coming here, going to the ammeter and to the load, the rheostat, and going back. Another connection is a parallel connection of a voltmeter with respect to the module. So this multimeter here is a parallel connection. As you can see here, one point is connected at the one side of the load, other is connected to the other side of the load, which is again parallelly connected to the module. So you can make this connection at this two point also. So this is the condition right now. You can see here, it shows zero voltage, and it shows about 0.37 ampere current, which is corresponding, zero voltage is corresponding to short circuit current, okay. Now which also means that this is at the right now low resistance value. If I change this, for example, I just show you, if I change this, see the voltage is increasing, and if you go to the other extreme, you will find a high value of voltage, which is corresponding to open circuit. But in practice, what you need to do is you need to vary this from very slowly from one point to the other point and make the measurements, okay. So the measurements are to be made in this following. So you need to fill this table. So you have the serial number, voltage, current, and power you can calculate. So if you take the, multiply the voltage and current, you can actually calculate the power also. Now here you can make this table as much as you want, but minimum 10 points and up to 20 points you should actually calculate. So from this experiment of measuring the IV characteristic of a single PV module, you need to measure this kind of characteristic. So again, you can actually start taking the reading. So take a value of current and the value of voltage, okay. Take another point here, measure the value of current and value of the voltage, right. As you can see, the current is not changing, but the voltage is changing significantly. Second thing, right, take another point, check the value of current and value of the voltage, change further, value of current, value of voltage. You will notice that the value of current is not changing, because if you remember in the short circuit mode, so because we are in this mode, okay, so here we are expecting a graph like this. So in this mode, till we are here, your current is not changing, but your voltage is changing, right, your current remains constant, and therefore right now you are not observing change in current. So you change another point, your voltage change, current slightly decreases 0.37 to 0.36, change another point, your voltage is now 13.3 volt, current remains same. Now you can see your current start decreasing, and voltage is 15.73, current 0.34, current is now changing 0.3, voltage is 17. So you are approaching now close to the open circuit voltage condition. So now your voltage will not change much, but your current will change. So this is the point in which is corresponding to your actual maximum power point, and therefore you need to take many data at this point. Your current is changing, so take many close points between this category, and now your current is decreasing 0.23, voltage is 18.14, current is further decreasing, and by taking many parameters points, you will actually come to the end of this point. So you will 0.18, 0.19 ampere and 18.53 volt, okay. Basically, when you go to the open circuit voltage, your current should become zero. So your resistance value should be, open circuit voltage means your resistance value should be infinite, very large value. Now this is only 100 ohm resistance, and therefore you are not able to measure the points lower than current corresponding to lower than 0.18, because you require very large value of resistance, but you know one open circuit points, right. So by taking this data, now you can plot this kind of curve. So you will get the current versus voltage. You can also do the measurement calculation of power. So you will plot the power versus voltage. So actually you can, from this point, you will find current versus voltage, you will also do the same graph, and you can find power versus voltage, and you will find that somewhere there is a power versus voltage will be like this, and somewhere there is a maximum power point formulas. What you also need to, so from this measurement you can find out this parameters, you can find out what is open circuit voltage, short circuit current. When you'll calculate the maximum power point, so voltage at maximum power point, current at maximum power point itself, that is the maximum power you are getting, and then efficiency. So your P max, which is nothing but IM times VM, and your PM needs to be measured. And as I said, this can be measured using pyranometer, or a reference solar cell will be given to you, and the value of the current of the solar cell will be actually measure of a PN and module area. So module area you can actually measure from the dimensions. PN is normally given in watt per meter square, and therefore your module area should be given in meter square. So if you have this, you can also measure the efficiency. You can also measure the fill factor of the module, which is ratio of IMVM divided by ISC VOC. So in this way, if you perform the experiment, you can find out the overall characteristic of a one single PV module. I hope this experiment is useful. Now once you do this experiment, you can actually calculate, you can compare what is the estimated value, what is the rated value of the PV module, and what is the measured value. You can do the comparison, and at the end of the experiment you will be able to answer many questions about a PV module and its characteristic. I hope you will learn many things from this measurement, and wish you all the best for performing this experiment. Thank you.